Hey guys, how are you?
Welcome to Simple Growth Chat. Okay, today I wanted to talk about how many different ways you can calculate square footage. There's really quite a few. All right, so first of all, the first way is to do a data pull from Zillow and get either the square footage for the yard or it's for the house. So like for cleaning, you could do the house or you could do the yard. Okay, so that's step one. Then 1A would be to take that quote and then you could multiply it by a percentage. So like if you're trying to go from gross down to net or to a square footage, you take a percentage. So that would be one, and that would be the second way. The third way, and we're just talking about yards and right now, the third way to do it for yards would be to do just small, medium, large, extra large. Like one of the clients I was talking to today, he said that he really wants to go simple. Simple as possible, which I totally get. And so what works for him is, how big is your yard? Small, medium, large, extra large. And he just kind of has a range in there and you pick that range and you calculate prices from there. So that would be the third way. The fourth way would be just to ask. So let's say you're trying to do a Zillow pull and then there's no rate in there. Then you just say, hey, it looks like you're not in our database. And then you could just ask them. Now, problem maybe with asking them is they may or may not know. So you just say like, give us your best estimate. But really the key is, so we have all these different ways of getting an estimate, like just for the yard. The key is always to make sure that in your chatbot that you are in your estimator, you're saying, this is based on our best estimate, but you could ask people how many square footage is your lawn. And then from there, let's talk about some of the other things like mulch and bedding and, garden cleanup. So there you can do that a couple of ways too. You can ask somebody, like, let's say it's mulch. Do you know how many bags you want? So you could do it by bags. You could ask, how much did you use last year? Like maybe they know. You could ask them to do a calculation. Say, all right, let's calculate your first bed. Length, width, and you do your next one. Length, width, next width, until they say they have no more beds for mulch. And the nice thing in there is when you're doing that calculation, you know, some put 3 inches, some put two, some put one. You guys do. And so you could build in that calculation based on how many inches. The third way for like a mulch type thing is just to say, give them the information. We charge this much for the trip and we charge this much per hour. Would you like our services? Because that's all some people want to know, right? You just wanted to get, what do your customers want to know to say yes, come out. Because once they come out, like they're yours, right? And so there's really just so many ways. There's not one way ever to just say, all right, this is our square footage and this is what it is. We want to, again, it's always about meeting our consumers where they're at. And really I find that different like locations, different like you have Canada, different countries, different states, different areas, people have different expectations. And so you want to be calculating your square footage and giving the opportunities based on what is happening in your area. Snow plowing, which sadly a lot of the country knows right now, right? I'm not sadly, I'm in Milwaukee. We got plenty, we're used to it. Snow plowing, again, there's multiple ways you can calculate that. Some people just do one, keep it simple guy, just one set price. You can ask how many cars wide and how many cars long. You could just say, is it small, medium, large? Like there's all these different ways and you have to do for one that fits your business, but two, that you're meeting your consumers where they expect. What is the norm in your area? Like, so what the norm in Wisconsin is probably length of your driveway. And maybe two cars wide. Like if I were to do a snowplow for myself, if I was doing that, I would just do like, how long is your driveway? And then we give them the tools to make that calculation. I think in a simple way, that's really the key too, like to make it as simple as possible within your estimator bot. So if I was gonna say, how long is your driveway? If somebody asked me off the top of my head, I'd be like, I don't know. But if I tell them, well, your car is about 20 feet long, I can do that calculation. Same with how many beds, how many square foot of mulch do you need? I don't know. But if you can ask them, you know, how many wide, how many long, I can do that. Another one is like trimming and pruning and hedges. So the easiest way like that I think would be to do maybe is to ask, how many hedges that are small, how many are large, how many are medium, but then tell them what it is. Because like I might think all mine are medium, but you would give them the square footage. The other thing you could do though, if you want to keep it simple, is like, how long is your hedge? Is it 20 feet? Is it 10 feet? So it's really, you have to think about when you're setting your estimator square footage is, what is the norm? what is really the bottom line information you need to go out, right? Because once you're out, they're yours. You want to take them off the market. So it's the bottom line information that you need. And then what do they know? What can they reasonably understand to give you? So I just kind of wanted to go live because we had like a new chat bot where it's simple. You know, it's like small, medium, large lot. And it just made me realize like we can fit whatever your industry norm is, and you really can too. So just to summarize, the three tips when you're figuring out square footage is: one, what is the minimum you need to get in that yard or get in that house? Two, can you do a pull from Zillow? Three, if it doesn't pull, like just get the ask information. And then the other thing to think about is what is the norm in your area? Like what are other people expecting you to ask them? Anyways, have a great day. Talk to you later about chatbots.